Reference children, in the previous class we have discussed about the physical features of India. Okay, today I would like to tell the new topic or new lesson, very interesting one. See, so can you imagine life without water? Anyone? Can you survive without water? No one can survive without water. So we cannot imagine the life without water. See, when you wake up from the when you wake up in the morning, so everything is interlinked with water only. We cannot do anything without water. See, so today we are depending on water. So every living thing is depending on water only. See, we are getting water from rivers, lakes, oceans, seas, and groundwater, under the ground also. So today our topic is India rivers. See, so we have four main directions. What are they? The main cardinal directions are north. Behind the north we have south. The right side of your hand it shows the east. Opposite direction is west. Okay? So north, south, east, west. Like that we have North India. India is divided into North India and South India. See, down South India. See, the Tropic of Cancer passes through Madhya Pradesh state and West Bengal, Tripura, like this. So, here the Tropic of Cancer up part is called as North India. Down side we have called as South India. See, we have two kinds of rivers are there. We have two kinds of rivers. Those are snow-fed rivers, rain-fed rivers. Snow-fed rivers. Second one, rain-fed rivers. So, what is the name of our national river? What is the name of our national river? Ganga. See, the Ganga river originates from the Gangotri glaciers. You know, here north side we have Himalayas. I already discussed in the previous class. The word Himalayas means home of snow. These mountains are covered with snow. From the Himalayas at the Gangotri glacier, there are two rivers, the Bhagirathi and Alaknanda. These two rivers are joins at one point and forms a Ganga river. What is the name of the river? Ganga. This river is a national river. Okay? This Ganga is a snow-fed river. And the second one is Yamuna. Yamuna also originates in Yamunotri glacier in Uttarakhand. Okay, this Yamuna also snow-fed river. And the next one is Brahmaputra. What is that? Brahmaputra. This Brahmaputra originates in Tibet and it enters into the Arunachal Pradesh. Then it drains into the Bay of Bengal. Okay. And fourth one is Indus.
Water is going to hydrate. Okay?
That's why maybe we will get a, we will see the large amount of water, especially in the rainy season, because of these rivers are rain fed rivers. These rivers are rain fed rivers. What are they? Narmada, Tapati, Mahanadi, Godavari, and here Krishna and Kaveri. Okay, these six rivers are central, central and south India rivers. That is nothing but rain fed rivers. So north fed rivers, north India rivers are called as snow fed rivers. These four rivers, what are they? Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra, Indus. These rivers are called as snow fed rivers. That means snow fed rivers means throughout the year water same. These rivers have the water same throughout the year. Coming to central and south India rivers, here Narmada, Tapti, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri and Mahanadi. These rivers are depending on rainfall. Okay, maybe we have more rain. Maybe we get to get more rain. We will see that more water in these rivers. Unfortunately, we will get very less rainfall. We will see the very less amount of water in these rains. Okay. So two kinds of rivers. What are they? Snowfed rivers and rainfed rivers. Okay. Don't get confused. See here the Indus, Narmada and Tapati. These three rivers are empties into Arabian Sea. Here Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, these rivers are there into the Bay of Bengal. Okay, Indus, Narmada, Tapati, these rivers are there into the Arabian Sea. Remaining rivers are empties or drain into the Bay of Bengal. Okay, don't get confused here. So what are the uses of rivers? Actually we have so many uses. We are using rivers water for bathing, cooking and washing clothes and etc. See, and the rivers are the sources of fish. Rivers are the sources of fish. Most of the people using the fish as a food. Okay, and across the rivers we are built the dams and it produce the electricity also. Okay, and rivers also used, rivers water also used drinking water after purification. We can use the rivers water as drinking water after purification only. Okay, and rivers water also used for industries. You know, industries are using rivers water to produce the goods. Okay, that goods rivers has another use also. We have another use also. Goods. We have to transport goods. We are transporting goods from one place to another using rivers. That means we are traveling through rivers. See, so we have so many uses of rivers. Actually, we cannot. So don't waste the water and don't pollute the rivers also. So some members are throw the garbage into the rivers and plastic covers. So change the attitude and don't pollute the rivers. Save water. Okay, without water we cannot live. So just imagination also very difficult without water. So we don't have any right to pollute the water especially. Okay, we are not creating water, just we are using natural resources. Rivers are the natural resources. Okay, we don't have any right to pollute the rivers or waste the water or pollute the water. Okay, today our homework is write down the snow fed rivers names and rain fed rivers names and send me a WhatsApp. Okay, thank you.